We'll cover how to run a goodness of fit test. To start, we'll need to do a couple of things. First, enter in the data into a list. For our dataset, we'll have 28 in the first bin, 18 in the second, 24 in the third, and 30 in the fourth. Next, we need to enter another list with the expected values for each of these bins. Here we expect the four bins to have equal probability and there are 100 observations, so we expect a count of 25 in each bin. Alright, now we can jump into test, then chi for chi-square test, and then choose GOF for goodness of fit, which is the same as a one-way chi-square test. We specify which list is our observed data by hitting F1 for list, and then entering the list number, which was 3. We do the same for the expected data list, and specify 4. And we also must specify the degrees of freedom, which in this case is 3. Recall that to get the degrees of freedom, we take the number of bins minus 1, when we have a one-way table. Finally, we also specify a list where the contribution to the test statistic will be reported. I'll use list 5. Hitting execute runs the test, and we get a test statistic of 3.36 and a p-value of 0.34. You can also double-check your degrees of freedom here and see which list to look in for the contribution of each bin to the test statistic. Let's hop out to the list view to see the contribution list. For example, here the contribution of the first bin was 0.36. We can show that by taking 28 minus 25, square that result, and then divide by 25, which is 0.36. Also, if you want to see a graph that visualizes the p-value, you can hop back into the test view for the chi-square goodness of fit test, scroll down to execute, and then hit F6 for draw. The shaded region will represent the p-value. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up below or leave a comment, and thanks for watching.